think we'll try and connect to Dr. Bhaskar Rao in just a bit. Let me go across to India's very own PPE man, Manish Mundra, who's been in Nigeria, but over the past 3 months has been helping doctors, policemen and other ordinary citizens with providing PPE kits from Nigeria. All of this through the power of social media. Manish, it's a pleasure to speak to you again. You've received a lot of accolade for the kind of selfless work you're doing through your own funds. And it's not just PPE kits, it's also funding and help through other means of kind, food, ration, also migrant workers who are, of course, facing the toughest challenge amongst us during this crisis. Where have you drawn your strength from, Manish, all this while?
Shivani, first of all, thank you for having me back here on the show. As you start the program saying this is one of the biggest challenges we as mankind are facing, we as people are facing on Earth, and it's our duty to see what role we can play and fit into. Of course, the doctors are there, the policemen and all are there on the front line doing their duties. But as citizens, we also have a role to play besides protecting ourselves. And I think most important thing which I could pick up was if we can quickly find ways and means to provide protection gear to all our frontline warriors and see if we can play that role and try and secure that design and get it done. So that was the first thing initially what we started with. But as we moved, we could see there were different layers of problems coming up. Like, for example, food became an issue, the rations became an issue, and we started addressing that. Then masks became an issue, ready meals, we started with that. And as we move forward, we see rehabilitation. When the migrants workers are moving on, their health, their hygiene, and their accommodation, etc., right, are becoming the issues. So more and more people are joining with more and more ideas to see how we can help the situation and protect our frontline warriors to do the job, focus the job on protecting the patients, helping them recover and taking care of them, but also protecting themselves to be strong enough to fight this. So we all are in this war against COVID, against this coronavirus, and all, as I said, including you, me, everybody has to play a role, and we pick and choose based on the moment, based on the situation. Like, for example, there were issues with respect to supplying
beds. Manish, I've noticed on your Twitter timeline, which you are using very efficiently to contact people, those who need your help, there are times when you sound very dejected, but then you get up the next day and you say, let's do more. That has become your hashtag, very popular one. So I want to understand from you that how do you keep your spirits up? Because there are challenges and there are, troughs in this journey. There are highs and also lows.
Yeah, of course, there are highs and lows, and we face experience bottlenecks as we go in because everything is unplanned. And we have to move and we get through experiences which pull you down. But also there are images, there are stories, and the points which come up, which again makes you pull up and say, look, guys, we have to do it. Otherwise, there's no other way. And everybody needs help of each other. So, of course, pushing down when we get shortchanged or some ideas don't click or don't work. But then pulling up, there are a lot of reasons when we see photographs, when we see images, when we hear news and other things and positivity, it makes you pull up and say, okay, let's go and do it again. So that's the whole idea, the curve on up and down is how we manage life, and we have to manage the situation and where we are.